All right, guys. So a lot of people have been wanting to know how I installed lights on my infraction truck, but you can do this for any car. Some kits actually come where, like for instance, my Traxxas Stampede 4x4. Let me grab that real quick. So my Stampede 4x4, Traxxas actually did a good job, and they designed this because they designed it so where they can have this light bar that's installed on the front of it. It's actually four LED lights, and you guys have seen me run this truck before, and these lights don't actually come inside the bucket, so it's like three or four pieces you get. The lights are separate from it, so you actually screw, turn this around just a little bit. So you actually screw them in there. Let's see if we can get a little light going. It may help out. You see these little screws on my fingers pointing at? So you actually screw these in, and that secures this light bucket here for the four lights. And then it's a wire that actually connects all these together, loops up through there, and then it actually connects to the receiver. Now, sometimes people will use like a little battery pack or something like that and connect to it as well. But I thought that was good that Traxxas did this when they designed this truck. They kind of had that in mind for it because there are mounts on the bumper for this. Now, like I said, some people install these, and it comes with a cord to actually install it directly into your receiver, or you can just, some people do modifications and solder directly to a battery or something and kind of attach it, the battery, to the inside of the body. Now, I'm not a big fan of that because it does kind of weigh the body and stuff down. But for the infraction, and kind of how I do a lot of my trucks and stuff, is you can take a drill or a body reamer and you can make holes in there. You don't want to make the hole so big that the light just pops out and it won't stay secure. Now, you want to make it so that take your body reamer or your drill and drill it big enough so that the light actually is a tight fit in there, because you're also going to put some shoe goo, or you may even want to use some, well, shoe glue is probably going to be the best thing to do, because it'll secure it in there a little bit, and it won't be as hard compact as glue will be. So give me one second. I'm going to tell you guys and show you guys the inside of this as well. All right, so just about any body that you see on the inside is not going to be pretty. So you guys can see there where I actually, after I made the holes for the lights, like I said, you want to make them, I can't stress that enough, you don't want to make it to where the light just slides in there easily and can fall out the front. You want to make it to where it's a tight fit. That's why a body reamer is going to be one of the better tools to use. Let me show you guys what that looks like, because some of you guys may be saying, "What is that? What are you talking about?" So this is one of the tools that I use, and if you guys don't have this, buy this because it's a very useful tool, especially if you start buying new bodies and stuff like that. But this tool is basically used when you buy a body and you have to put holes in it somewhere else, or sometimes you buy bodies and they have little marks where you can actually make holes. You just take this, push this in, and start twisting it, and as you twist it, it's going to actually turn and dig into the body. And it's gonna, as you see, it can dig there and it can go all the way down and make a hole pretty big. I don't know, that's probably about, I'd say about an inch or so in diameter there. But you can do that with this. It's just, as you turn, it's just gonna kind of make a perfect hole into the body. So that's what I do for my lights, front and rear. You guys see in the rear, it is a little bit smaller. And like I said, I did make it to where the lights barely fit up in there. I mean, it's a very tight fit. And then what I do is I can take some shoe goo and I'll put it actually on the light buckets. I'll kind of put a little bit around the light and then I'll slide the light in. And since it's tight, some of the glue will come to the outside, and then I just put some on the outside of it to secure that in. I don't put a lot on there, but I do put it over the wires of the actual light too, because that keeps that wire pretty secure. And then this extra tape is just kind of extra protection. You see there's a lot of junk and gunk in there, and then the wire comes up through here. So one of the things you guys need to consider when you excuse me, think about doing lights for your car, is consider what kind of lights you're going to use and make sure that they can fit in the vehicle. Because with these particular light set, I had to actually do some soldering because the body's a lot wider than the actual truck I took this off of. So I actually had to do some cutting and soldering some more wires and stuff to make it wide enough for it to fit. Because if I didn't, they would have, I think it was about 2 or 3 inches, the extension on the wires there. So I had to do, you guys can't really see too much there, but I did do some cutting and some soldering up in there for that, for this to fit. But there's tons of different light kits out there. Some of you guys that do this a lot, go ahead and if you can, put some information in the comments and then put some links as well. I'll try to make sure that it doesn't get flagged and not put those links out there. But that's basically what you can do for lights. And these particular light sets that I have on here, excuse me, actually route through my receiver. I think I got it connected through, I don't think the battery, I think I got it connected to the third channel. I can't remember how. But you also want to make sure, let me show you guys one other thing as well. Now, I don't remember the exact part number, but this is an extension basically. This routes into my receiver, and this is long enough to where it actually connects into that connection for the lights for the body. Now, I had a shorter one in here, and the problem I was having, you guys might have saw in one of my videos, when I hit a couple bumps, it actually came loose. This is longer so that when I hit a bump, it's not so tight that it actually snatches out and stuff. I can't remember the part or anything for this, but when you guys start working on this, when you guys in there, I got some pretty smart people out there that subscribe to me and stuff. You guys know probably exactly what this is and the part number for it. I just can't recall right off the hand. It's pretty late right now. But put that in the comments down below, because that's going to help other people out as well when they install this light kit. So the first thing you guys want to make sure you do is you want to pick a light kit that's going to fit on the body. And like I said, there's tons of different variations. You can go to your local hobby shop, and you can probably go to Fry's and get away with going to looking at some lights and stuff on Fry's as well. You want to make sure that the voltage and stuff is correct for it as well, because the lights do drain your battery. It's not like they only drain a little bit. The brighter the lights and the more lights you have, it's just like anything else, electric. It's just going to draw that current from that battery on that. So, and that's basically how I do my lights for my kids. Basically all of them. You guys have seen, I've had some in the past before, where I've put lights on cars. If I just wasn't going to do it for this body just yet, but then I decided to go ahead and do it because I didn't really want to tear this body up too much, or just start ripping it apart, or just start doing modifications to it too much until it became available. But of course, now it's available. So I went ahead and decided to do this, and I got a couple other plans for this body. Like, I'm going to make some holes in here and stuff for air and stuff like that. But anyway, that'll be a whole separate video. So anyway, I wanted to show this to you guys. Like I said, put your comments down below. A lot of you guys who do this a lot, especially put your comments and some links and stuff to some of the stuff you guys do as well, and I'll try to make sure it doesn't get flagged. So anyways, don't forget to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks for watching, guys.